In the next couple of lectures, we're going to talk about data handling, data storage, and data retention. Data handling is an administrative control. We only want individuals that are trusted, that should have access to the data, to be able to handle it and, well, access it. We have very clear policies on who can access the data, how, when, and why they're allowed to access it, which then feeds back to our need to know. And then we should have auditing and logs in place to make sure that after the fact, we can confirm whomever accessed that data had a good reason to do so. I think in most places where I have worked, we've had pretty good logs, but not all the places would have that backend audit system. For the exam, remember, perfect world, so I assume that we do. We have that top-down IT security governance approach that we would want in our organization. People are always more important than stuff, and we have the time and the money to do your due diligence and do your due care. So for the exam, we have that backend system that can confirm this is who accessed the data, this is when they did it. So if any red flags are raised, they would need to explain why they accessed that data. Now, how we store our data is, of course, also very critical. The attackers always look for the weakest link. If, for instance, we use backup tapes, well then, the backup tapes should be kept in a secure, climate-controlled facility that is preferably geographically distant. Because while the majority of the restores that we do are not critical, it's most likely just a user that deleted some files and they need to restore them, we're still going to have the rare ones, the ones that are actually very important, where we have a disaster. And for those, we want to make sure that the backup tapes are stored at that geographically distant location where they're not going to be affected by the same disaster we had, but it's still not going to take an excessive amount of time to get the tapes because we need to be able to restore from those tapes in a reasonable amount of time and in a reasonable manner. So far enough away without being too far away. And when we decide where that is, here we would look at our MTD, the maximum tolerable downtime. If our MTD is 4 hours and it's going to take us 2 hours to restore the system using the backups, well then that leaves us at the most 2 hours to get the hardware up and running, the software installed, before we need to do the restore. So if the company that delivers the backup tape or we drive to the location, if that's going to take us 4 hours, well then we're past the MTD. And all of this is something that we do in our disaster recovery plan. We do the testing, then we do the walkthrough, and then we might realize the tapes are going to be there too late. Well, then we need to negotiate another deal with whomever is storing our tapes, or we might need to find another vendor. Another caveat here. It is very normal for the vendor to come out to our facility and pick the tapes up. Whomever they have to come out and pick our tapes up have to be licensed and bonded, meaning if they, for whatever reason, lose those tapes, they are liable and they have insurance. In most of the places I have worked in, we have had a list. These are the 10 people that are allowed to come and pick up our backup tapes. We have a printout with their picture, their name, and they have to show some sort of ID before they get the tapes. If someone shows up who's not on that list, they don't get our tapes. And most places use backup tapes because they're relatively inexpensive and you can store a ton of data on them. And when I say a ton of data, the last ones I saw in use were LTO8s. Their native capacity is about 12 terabytes and their compressed capacity is about 30 terabytes. That is a ton of data on a tape that's not very big. For the people in the US who haven't seen backup tapes before, they are about 4x4 inches and then maybe slightly less than an inch tall. I think it's 0.85. From the people outside of the US who've never seen them either, that's about 10x10 centimeters and then about 2 centimeters tall. So really not that big. And now for some tape horror stories. Some of them are older, some of them are not. Both the ones that I have heard about and the ones that I have experienced are of things that we shouldn't do. With some of them, people said, well, we need an offsite storage for our tapes. We don't really have the budget for it, so I'm just going to take them home with me. If something happens, we have the tapes. But the tapes were unencrypted. Someone broke into their house, and now all that confidential information was stolen. I've seen some places where they have them in storage cabinets, so employees can go in, grab a pen, some paper, some paper clips, and a couple of backup tapes with our unencrypted data. And then finally, my own example, when I was working as a project manager to relocate a large data center in Hawaii, we found more than 10,000 storage tapes under the floor of the data center. I mean, it was more secure than some of the other examples because most people wouldn't have access to that subflooring in the data center. On top of that, why would they look under the floor? But some of those tapes were tapes that we needed to restore data with. What if there had been a disaster in the data center? Well, all that would be lost because all the backups were in the same room as the actual servers. So yeah, horror stories. But these are actual decisions where people thought this is a good idea, or at least it's a solution to a problem. Well, you and I obviously understand we need to keep our data secure at all stages on all media, and all media means all media. We can't have that weak link in our chain. Our papers needs to be just as protected as the tapes. You should assume that the attackers are very good at what they do. They do a ton of research before they even attack. Now, if they learn we have pretty good defense in depth, well, then they're not going to try to attack the actual servers. That would be a waste of time. But if they find out that we keep our storage tapes downstairs next to the public restroom, well, then they'd really just need to get access to that restroom and then break into the room next to it where the tapes are kept. And now, after all that gloom and doom, let's look at data retention. It's very common in large organizations to have petabytes and petabytes of data. And it's just not feasible to keep all that data on our disks, especially if it's not data that we actively use all the time. If we are in finance or in healthcare or in many other areas, there are certain requirements on how long we have to keep certain data. So we use a ton of backup tapes. Let's say it's patient records. Well, then they need to be kept forever, meaning every time we do a backup, that backup gets sent to the backup facility and it's going to sit there as long as we are in business. If we go out of business, then it's a requirement that that data gets transferred to someone in the same field. Now, if we are the same hospital and we have our payroll records, let's say they have a 7-year retention, then we do a weekly full backup. We send that backup to a backup facility and then it just sits there for 7 years. Unless, of course, for some reason we needed to restore with. Let's say that's never the case. We don't ever have to restore from that specific tape. Well, then after 7 years, that tape is returned to us from the backup facility. And since it is 7 years old, it's unlikely we're going to reuse that tape. So we need to destroy it because we need to keep our data as long as it is required by law or it is useful. And the last part, the as long as it is useful, we need to take with a grain of salt because there might be privacy laws that prevents us from keeping the data as long as we want just because we think it's useful. If we go back to the example with the payroll records, we keep them for 7 years. Now we can dispose of them. There are no legal requirements for us to keep them any longer, but there might be a privacy law that says we have to destroy them now. Well, then we have to. Now, if that privacy law is not there and we want to do some analytics on our payroll data, well, then we can. We can keep it. Once that's done, we will probably destroy the tapes. In most cases, though, once the retention is over, we just get rid of the backup. And this is where you, as a good cybersecurity professional, needs to understand and know the laws and regulations that govern your country, your state, and that are specific to the line of business that your company is in. And with that, we are done with this lecture. Thank you for being here, and I will see you in the next one.